Hello everyone, how are you all? I'm Saurabh Sharma, assistant professor at SC College of Commerce. And today we are going to study the new topic of public finance for the BCom second year. That is classification of taxes. This is the most important and the unsung topic of the public finance. That is direct classification of taxes. And the classification of taxes is direct, proportional, progressive, consumption, regressive, defensive, and indirect, specific, ad valorem, single, and multiple. And the other is income and property, production and capital goods, VAT, and more VAT. In this video, we will talk about this tax only. Which one? That direct taxes. And what are the direct taxes? Proportional, progressive, consumption, regressive, and defensive. Let's talk about it. According to Dilton, a direct tax is really paid by the person on whom it is legally imposed. It means person A, person B. Person A is a government. Person B is taxpayer. And there is no link between the A and B. Directly paid by B to A. When the tax is paid by the assessee or the taxpayer directly to the government, there is no interlink. Then in that case, we call it the direct tax. It means direct tax is the really paid by the person on whom it is legally imposed. While an indirect tax is imposed on one person. Indirect tax is on one person but paid partially or wholly by another person owing to the consequential changes in the terms of the some contract or bargaining between them. Okay, J.S. Mill, a direct tax is one demanded from the very person who is intended or desired should pay it. Indirect taxes are those taxes which are demanded from one person and in exception and intention what we shall identify him expense of another. It means direct taxes paid by the person and to the government directly. Indirect tax is paid by the B to C and C paid to the government, that is A. Indirect tax, in case of indirect tax, there is a mediator. Okay. According to the Gladstone, the direct and indirect tax are like two alternative sisters between whom an exchange should be perfectly impartial. According to P.E. Taylor, authority of public finance distinguished direct and indirect tax as follows. The term direct and indirect tax are finally distinguished in meaning only and in terms of shiftability. Only shiftability is responsible in direct and indirect tax distinguish. Direct tax are not shiftable and indirect tax are shiftable. That's it. From the above, we can reach the conclusion that direct tax are those tax which are paid by the person on whom these may imposed. Paid by on whom these are imposed. And the real burden is also borne by them. the burden of such tax cannot be transferred, burden cannot be transferred or shifted to any other person. That is, in that case, indirect tax, direct tax, both impact and incidence fall upon the same person. Okay. Let's talk about the types of taxes. That means progressive, proportional, regressive, and degressive taxes. A tax that is progressive, proportional, regressive, degressive according to the relationship. If tax is increasing with the help of income, if income is increasing and tax is also increasing, it means this is progressive tax. Okay, let's take an example. 3000, if income is 3000, then tax is 10%, which is 300. If income is 4000, tax rate is 50%. As income increase, rate of tax also increase and collection of tax also increase. 4000 to 5000, income increase and tax also increase, 15 to 20 and collection also increase. If income increase 5000 to 6000, income is 25, tax to 20 to 25%. If income is 1000 and if the income is increased, tax is increased, the tax collection is also increased. Okay guys, you can see there is a difference of 300 and 400 and 500. That taxation is increasing, rate is increasing, and the net collection is also increasing. Okay guys, let's talk about the proportional tax. What is proportional tax? Proportional tax means a tax which remain the same at any level of income. If income is 1000, tax is 10%. If income is 2000, tax is 10%. If income is 3000, the tax is even at 10%. But the collection amount of taxation is increasing because the income is increasing. Income increase, but the tax rate remain the constant. Income increase, tax rate remain the constant. Income increase, but the tax rate remain the constant. But collection difference is 100, 100, and 100. Okay, guys. Let's talk about the regressive tax system. If income is 1000, income increase 1000 to 2000. Income increase, the tax rate decrease. What kind of joke is this? If income increase, then tax rate is also increased. It means you are charging the more tax on the poor people, rather less tax on the richer people. What kind of joke is this? You are creating the inequality. We call the tax as a social equalization tool because tax eliminates the difference between the rich and the poor person. And you are charging more tax on the poor people and high tax rates on the low tax rate on the rich people. And as the income increase from 2000 to 3000, tax rate also decreasing. This tax rate, this system of tax is not followed generally in the economies because this type of tax system is maybe done in the capitalist economy. Okay. But the country like India cannot impose this type of taxes because it will create the huge political issue. that the opposition party will tell that the that income is increasing, that tax rate is decreasing. What kind of taxation system is this? Income is 1,000, tax rate is 10%. Income is 1,000 to 2,000 and the tax rate becomes 10% to 8%. It means income is increasing and tax rate is decreasing. If the BJP government do this, the other political parties will create the huge disturbance. Okay, that's why generally we do not impose a regressive tax system in the democracy. It can create only and only in the federal system. Okay. Bye bye. Take care. We will study the next topic in the next video. Bye bye and take care.